previously on Happily Ever Hanks. We departed the Pacific time zone in a hurry, heading 1,500 miles east with one goal in mind, to see the total solar eclipse. After overloading on groceries and supplies in New Mexico, we felt ready to tackle the influx of crowds for this event. What we didn't prepare for was the temperamental weather in Texas, and the unexpected repairs coming our way. There's always something in the RV life, and that something turned into many somethings in the blink of an eye.
I don't think the traffic was, like, anything to write home about.
Yeah, there's no one on the road. Maybe tomorrow will be the bad day.
Yeah. So I don't know when check-in actually is here. So we're just gonna go for it. I don't know where else to go. If they won't let us check in, then we'll just kind of ask if we can hang out in the parking lot. Like, we'll just come back here, I guess. It's just crazy how you perceive this to be all chaotic for the eclipse. It sounds like everyone just takes off, like, the day of the eclipse, sees it, and they're gone. And that's why it gets so chaotic in a short amount of time.
To get this cool shot, I tell her just drive just a little bit. What does she do? Drive halfway down the road. Now Carl has to go running. Nay, nay.
What in the office?
No one here?
I don't know.
It says checkout time 2:00, official check-in 3, and it is 11:52. Maybe the site will be closed or something.
Yeah, they might not even have anyone working here. They got us. Official check-in time is 3. Yeah. Holy cow.
I know. We're way early.
I thought, like, maybe 1. Oh, shoot. So no one's even here till 1 p.m. We're kind of stuck.
Usually when we're in these scenarios, we like to frequently rely on that saying, one crisis at a time. Because there's 500 things going on in your head at once, but you just got to pick one thing, fix that problem, move on to the next. It's like that muscle you got to keep working out, because if you don't stay on top of it, it's easy to get distracted with 20 different things at one time. Ask me how I know.
Well, we just got the RV backed in, so we're not blocking anything, but a couple checking out. We're, you know, checking to see if we need anything, and we told them our situation, and they basically were like, oh, we camp here all the time, and we know the people work here, and
they're very lenient, so they just gave us the gate code.
Yeah, they just said, well, if there's lots of sites open, here's the gate code. They're just gonna want you to go get set up at your site, and then you can just come back to check in. We're just gonna do that. Get us in there, Carl. Get us in. Oh, nice.
We got the hookups. Man, those brakes back there, I don't know, it sounds weird.
Well, they're very hot.
Do me a favor real quick. I'm gonna pull over right here and just, I want you to film the tires as I'm driving by. I wanna see if we can hear anything.
Go this way. Go ahead. That just does not sound normal. I'm gonna have to do some Googling when we get set up here. I don't know. I think the other side makes the noise too.
Did it sound pretty bad?
It sounds pretty loud on the right front one. It sounds like the drum. Something with the brake drum. When you fix one thing, there's something else that needs, like, it's routine maintenance, it's constant upkeep.
No. One crisis at a time.
No one seems to suspect a thing. Everyone's waving at us, so that's a plus.
No one's, like, yelling at us.
Everyone's like, come on in.
But somebody could be in our sight. We don't know. I'm pretty sure we're, like, on the end here. Which is great, because I wanted, like, something with not a lot of trees. Hashtag Starlink. Oh, there she is. D10. We're good. Yeah, that's just not sounding... not sounding good. I don't want you to go off the curb here, so unfortunately don't cut it yet. It's gonna be wonky. You're gonna end up in the grass over here. Okay, start cutting it now. You can start to straighten out, just don't straighten out 100%. Just kind of like start straightening out. Okay. Oh my goodness, this is beautiful. This is nicer than most RV parks that charge you like $85 a night. Like, the left side is off, but you're making your way in. So start to push it towards the driver's side to straighten it out. Nice. Okay. Perfect. Okay. Stop right there.
I don't know. Maybe the RV's just falling apart. It's time to get a new one.
What's up?
I don't see what's going on with that yet, but look down and look across the way.
Oh, another one.
Should have listened to everybody when they said you should replace both.
Oh, man. Again. That's crazy. Oh, man. We just got that done. We should have got both sides done, huh?
Well, we knew we were going to eventually get both sides done. We were a little late.
Yeah.
You know?
Carl, why don't you listen to everyone?
This, I'm not sure. I think we need to get an expert in here. It's always, the timing's always never good, but...
Tomorrow's Monday.
And the eclipse.
Let's get set up, get internet ripping, and then we'll figure it out.
Puzzle didn't make it!
Well, don't waste that. Do not waste this. We'll use this for chicken later.
Oh, smart. Okay. So we'll just get puzzle contaminants all over our chicken.
Yeah, that's fine. We'll cook it off.
Hey, you want to watch a movie tonight?
Oh, yeah, but let's go watch it upstairs.
Oh, okay.
Can you just make sure the lights are off?
Okay.
My goal every single night is to get the bed to myself for as long as possible. Yeah, it's that comfortable. The sleep quality, the comfortability, it's everything we needed to live full time in our RV. Hey, did you remember to lock the door?
Yeah, I did already.
Can you just double check?
Really?
Okay. The best part, shipping nationwide for free. They even ship it in this cute little box that is so easy to get inside your RV. Open it up, boom, you have an awesome new mattress. Rest assured, you get 120 nights to try out the bed, which is really nice peace of mind. Wait, can you also?
Shh. I got snacks.
Get in here. A big thank you to RV Mattress by Brooklyn Bedding for sponsoring this fun video. Be sure to head on over to rvmattress.com/happilyeverhanks to enjoy a 25% off discount. Rest assured that Memorial Day discounts are going on all throughout May, so you can get high quality at a low price.
You're hanging on by a thread here. The clouds come and go, and they're toying with my emotions right now. I think we only have like an hour, maybe an hour and a half until this eclipse is gonna take place. And if these clouds are covering it and we just drove halfway across the country, I'm gonna lose my mind.
Limping on a broken leaf spring.
You gotta laugh to keep from crying.
I have a window right here to look out. I can assess the situation as we go along. We have a huge lawn area right outside our RV, so I imagine a lot of people are going to flock from the woods onto our campsite, which is totally okay. We've been inviting some people to come hang out and just check it out.
To our surprise, we were able to have a local truck and recovery service come to the campground about 1 hour before totality. By the way, the reason we decided to change our plans last minute and not stay at a harvest host for the eclipse was due to the area experiencing some intense heat followed by harsh thunderstorms. Dry camping in a field with no electricity would have made for a rough scenario given our circumstance and the weather.
All right, game plan. So he went off to go find new leaf springs, so hopefully he's gonna be able to find not only one, but two of them.
Okay.
So we're waiting for that. Solar eclipse in an hour. Bad weather tonight, really bad winds. The mechanic said be careful of the winds because being on the lake, he says it will rip canopies right off.
Wow. No one gives you reassurance ever.
No, they're just like, yeah, no. So got to worry about that. We'll see. One crisis at a time. That's still up on jacks, by the way, like a car jack.
Oh.
Yeah, the axle's completely free of the axle hangers, so it's just floating there now while he ran into town to go find another leaf spring. We'll just have to be careful with the steps because we're unlevel.
Yeah.
And we'll just kind of go from there.
Yeah, I would make sure, like, if he comes back, he's not, like, touching the auto level. Or, you know, I mean, or messing with the jack. Like, we need to
Sure. Yeah, okay. Yeah, we'll have the steps up and the door shut and everything.
Like, do you ever tell them, like, just let
us know? Yeah, he let me control it always. Like, hey, can you lift up the trailer? He's not like, go ahead and do that.
I know, but sometimes they release the jack when they're done and say, hey, I'm releasing the jack, but do they know about the steps?
Well, we're going to leave the steps up.
We'll leave them up, okay.
Yeah.
So if you have to run in for anything really quick, it's going to be like really inconvenient and kind of a rush. Like,
yeah, we'll have to keep taking the steps down and up and stuff. The kitchen slides all slid in, so we just got to make sure we're not putting anything. Like, we have everything kind of slid in here, so one step at a time.
But yeah, the eclipse is happening. I mean, we might be able to go out with our glasses and see the partial.
Really?
You want to go?
Yeah, let's go try it.
Sir, your really attractive sunglasses. And guys, they're safe. We got them out of a Cracker Jack box, so we're fine. No worries.
Cool.
Put the steps up now, right?
Yeah, just steps in case. Up.
Just, if you're not sure why we keep stressing about the steps, because these make contact with the ground, you would adjust them after auto leveling. But if you were to put these steps down and then you auto leveled the rig with these steps down and the door shut, it could actually cause, like, just not goodness. Just, I don't know what it would cause, but I ain't gonna stick around the truck, find out.
Break it.
Everything's broken.
Nice.
We're okay. We're okay. Oh.
Really? Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
It's so cool. I've never seen that before.
I can't hook these over my ears. I'm so nervous.
Well, I can't see.
I can't see anything. Oh, wow. That is nuts.
Isn't that cool?
That's trippy. I feel really small.
Is all the people that we found for the eclipse, like, yeah. This is fantastic. Like, we're having like a little Hanks meetup at the same time we're watching totalities.
This is RV life to the fullest. We have one of our tires off, jacked up axle in the background. You just gotta make best with the amount of time you have.
RV life.
Renee's getting some footage and she's actually able to squeeze out a few pictures here, which is cool with the eclipse. Hopefully you guys can be seeing this right now because it's amazing.
Fuzzy because that's how dark it is.
That was so cool.
Isn't that neat?
You've never seen anything like that. When you look at it, it feels like you're in a really big room.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden it's like three-dimensional between the sun and the moon.
Yeah.
Got those new leaf springs replaced finally. That was, whew, headache. Poor guy. It's so hot out here.
I guess this is getting that lined up, huh?
Yeah, and it's a beveled.
But after he did, I noticed how much it actually raised the height of the trailer. I mean, just the leaf springs themselves are fresh and not really broken in. So the whole profile of the trailer is raised up even more so. Like, check out these steps.
Before they were on the ground, and now I gotta push them down. So yeah, high profile, baby.
Hopefully, fingers crossed, that will be enough of that for a while. Now I just gotta get these wheel bearings addressed because I think that's our next issue is that. The never-ending list of things to do. All right, let's go get cool. It's hot. I could use another total eclipse here to cool down the temperatures in Texas. Maybe a while.
Yeah, that's the adjuster that adjusts the brakes.
Goodness gracious.
What? So that's the noise, because that's just all been like exploding.
Look at all this. Look at all this. This was our brake. We don't know how long it's been like this for, but what is all this wiring here?
That is the magnet.
Oh, the magnet. Okay. Wow. That.
So he just took that apart, and that piece that just collapsed, like the brake there, just kind of fell down. And
fell down.
That's what I always say, to figure out what's broken, sometimes you just gotta look at it. Take it apart.
All right, all done. Let's wrap her up. And
You know what? We don't even really need a tire. It's just, just like.
What I would do now, if it was mine, is I would Google and try to find the brakes, all this hub in one piece.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's probably in Texarkana, and we can probably run and get it.
Google is a good friend. Okay.
Yes.
You see these five bolts here? You can take those out, and that whole plate will come off. And you just buy the whole plate.
Oh, and just put it back on.
It comes as one piece.
I would actually look at getting two of them. And the reason I say that is because you remember when I filmed and I heard the sound here, but I was like, I kind of hear it on the other side a little bit, on the front one. So I'm just saying, just in case that one acts up more, we might have to like replace both at one point.
Yeah, that probably would be
RV brake parts. Boom.
See, this is what happens when you tell the Hanks, I know how to fix stuff.
So that, it used to be a complete assembly.
Yeah, this went together like this.
I'm pretty sure that probably what failed was the adjuster. It probably got so far out.
Yeah.
That the adjuster came apart, but all the bearings look good.
I was thinking
the new one will come with new bearings, but the bearings look good. They're not worn.
Hi there. I was going to see if you guys had a brake assembly drum, like an entire brake assembly in stock at your location.
Okay, so here's the situation. We sent Carl to go get us a new brake hubless assembly because ours is completely shot, like it's just shattered. But what they suggested, which is really smart, and what we should have done when we broke one side of leaf springs, like having both replaced. They said if one drum is handling all the brakes now, that it's gonna affect the other side. If your tire's making weird noises, it might not be your wheel bearings, it might just be that your entire brake shattered.
So I got the old one there, and then I ended up getting two more to go. I'm pulling into the campground now, and I just got to thinking, you remember that one time we were RVing way out in the Boontillies? We were in the desert, Southern California, Sawtooth Canyon. Is that what it was? And I said, what is that noise? Like Renee stopped us.
Why does that sound so bad? Keep going.
Trailer brakes went out at that time, like they had already just disintegrated. We've been driving on this for way longer than we realize. I'm gonna say probably.
I've come bearing gifts.
Oh, bearing gifts.
That's, he only marked one that says left. So let's see here.
Oh, that looks more like what it's supposed to look like.
This is left.
Okay.
So this one will be the driver's side.
And the bearings didn't come with it, huh?
I bought extra new ones here. Yeah, so we got full new bearings and crimp connections. We got everything, the whole shebang here.
Wow.
And I even got a grease gun so we can grease them up good then, too.
So he took that piece off, that backing plate. He just took all those, like, the screws right
so
there.
So this is technically the backing plate now?
Yeah, that's the new backing plate.
Okay.
When you mash your brake in the truck,
okay.
Push your little lever,
yeah.
This magnetizes and it pulls to that hub.
Okay.
And when it does that, mechanically, it spreads these out. Here, see them move right there?
Oh, yeah.
And it magnetizes against that hub,
yeah.
The drum. It pulls in, and when the wheel rolls, it puts pressure on that, and it spreads these out to your drum.
Interesting. Okay. Is this like the brake pad right here?
That is the brake pad.
Okay. Gotcha.
Is a car brake system look like this, too? Or
The drum brakes are similar, but the disc brakes are totally different.
Disc brakes, because you can get disc brakes on an RV, right?
Yes, you can.
Yeah, okay.
You can replace these with disc brakes, actually.
Because I always hear people say they get disc brakes, and it's like an upgrade or something.
A lot of people upgrade to disc brakes, they do.
Maybe that will be us one day.
No, we're putting these on.
It's so pricey, though, those disc brakes. That independent suspension, the Moride.
Right.
Oh, my goodness.
This is a seal.
Okay.
That's a brake seal. This bearing here will go all the way in there.
So the larger one?
Yeah,
kind of sits on the inside.
Yeah, it goes like one goes on like this. That black, big black piece.
Yeah.
Will ride on this, and that's what you're riding on when you're going down the road.
Interesting.
Oh.
Okay, gotcha. So you never want to get this grease because the brake sits in here, and that could prevent it from actually breaking because it's trying to grip onto something slippery. Makes sense.
You're just trying to feel all the cavities and get rid of as much air as you possibly can.
Okay.
try to get it as close to center as you can.
Sure.
And just, and it's got to fit, that seal goes on that. Exactly. It only goes on one way. It's
okay.
Got that D side in there.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Yep, mm-hmm. That makes sense. Is that the one you only kind of tighten
right.
just enough to get snug? Okay. It's going to be a brand new RV by the end of the day.
Yeah, how about it?
Just keep rolling it and you'll feel the bearing tighten up.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
All right, you tighten it up and I'll you got spin it. It. Just, it won't take much now.
Okay. That might be good.
That'll be good. And this keeps that nut from turning.
Oh, interesting. Okay. Mm-hmm. So that's pretty important.
That is pretty important.
Remember how we said that both sides of the trailer brakes were making noise? Subscribe and stay up to date because we're going to be investigating that side next. Wondering how we actually afford this lifestyle? Well, check out this video next because we're going to be breaking down our strategies to the point where they work so well, it almost feels like cheating. We'll see you next week.